In my country, Tunisia, revolution was started and is still going on by the construction of a new modern state. But it has three components. There is a first component that is political. The political responsibility here lies with the people now. And this means that dignity is represented by the capacity of the people to feel, I am appointing the president, I am appointing the members of parliament, government is going to come from members of parliament. If we are unhappy with these people, we're not gonna vote for them. That's power. And that's dignity, that's political dignity. But there are two other sides of dignity that we should not forget. Democratization doesn't stop there. Dignity is also economic. And by economic dignity, we mean there should be enough investments conducted by government and conducted by the private sector in order to create this growth that is very badly needed. Because if we distribute evenly the results of growth, and growth is small, then you will distribute evenly poorness. And this will be the failure of democracy. And the third part of dignity is the social dignity. People need to feel that when they work, they will benefit from that. They will not be deprived of their contribution to the wealth creation. So this is not necessarily a discussion between groups, labor unions, bosses, state. No. This system has to be thought intelligently. Like the system of democracy is being thought intelligently, the system of wealth creation and wealth distribution has to be thought of intelligently, and this is what the southern neighborhood of Europe requires now.